the vow that has been pronounced upon your destiny, that you shall remain the way you are, that vow has been completely erased. There is a prayer that we have to pray very quickly now. The Bible says, surely they shall gather together, but not by me. Said, whosoever, either big or small, whosoever, either knowingly or unknowingly, whosoever, either a child or a boy or a girl or a man, whosoever that shall gather together against you, they shall fall for thy sake. That is what the Bible says. Standing on that scripture now, you are going to shout this very loud and very clear. Say, every evil meeting that is going on right now because of me, either in your marketplace or in your compound, on your place of work, or in the witchcraft coven, anywhere, every evil meeting that is going on right now because of me, you will now raise up your voice with a very powerful anger. Very powerful anger. Let that anger show in your voice. You will now say, scatter! Let me hear you. You are going to shake your scatter now. Let me hear you now. No. It's too soft. No, that kata is too soft. Every evil meeting that is going on right now because of me, kata! That is how to pray it. That is how to fight the battle. Rabuka la poto sokotayaba. Jesus' mighty name we pray. Father, we bless you tonight. Tonight is a night of warfare. It's a night of battle. We are not fighting to get victory. We are fighting from the point of victory. Because you have overcome for us. Father, accept our thanks in the name of Jesus. Anything that belongs to anyone here that has been tied down somewhere tonight, let that thing be released in the name of Jesus. Everyone here tonight, your prayers tonight will not go in vain. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Please have your seat. Some weeks back, we look at a very deep topic. And I believe the Lord has not finished what He wants to do with that message, which we title Break the Mirror Altar. So tonight is part two. Break the mirror altar. Those who are here, when we did the part one, we started with Isaiah chapter 54, verse 17. That says, no weapon that is formed against thee shall prosper. And we were told that anything that is called a weapon is an instrument designed to fight. It is an instrument designed to attack. And then we are told that day that when you look at a mirror, that mirror in the hands of so many people, in the house of so many people, that they are not ordinary mirrors. That many mirrors, they are actually death traps. And we are told that this kind of weapon in our environment is used to terrorize, to confuse, and to kill. We are able to expose ourselves to 22 activities that were connected to dark mirror that day. If you are not here, get the tape, get the CD. So that you will understand where we are coming from. Now listen very carefully. One of the deepest information that you can get about the mirror altar in the Bible is found in the book of Job.
Job
37. Please open your Bible to the book of Job, chapter
37.
Verse 18. If you don't understand deep things, this scripture will mean nothing to you. Also, if you don't understand deliverance, this scripture may not really mean much to you. Job 37.
Job 37.
Verse 18. It says, hast thou with him spread out the sky, which is strong, and as a molten looking glass. Hast thou with him spread out the sky, which is strong, and as a molten looking glass. One version of the scripture says, you have spread out the firmament or the sky, which is very strong, and which looks like a mirror that reflects. Another version of the Bible says it like this, which is even more clearer. It says, are you with him when he spread out the sky, which is not weak, but strong, and which was molded after a mirror that shows its images. What a very deep scripture. When you look at it closely, you can deduct two important facts from that scripture. Number one, the sky is picture as a mirror. It's picture as a mirror. In other words, when some people look at the mirror, they are actually looking at the sky. Not mirror anymore. According to this scripture. The second thing that you can deduct from this verse is that the sky that is pictured as a mirror, the Bible says, is very strong. A sensible question needs to be asked. What made the sky to be strong? What kind of strong is the Bible talking about? When you look at the sky, what exactly are you seeing? Thank God that the Bible too gave us the answer. Turn with me to the book of Genesis chapter 1. You compare scripture with scripture. Genesis chapter 1. Look at verse 6 and 7. And God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the water, and let it divide the water from the water. And God made the firmament, that is the sky, and divided the waters which were under the firmament from the waters which were above the firmament, and it was so. Which means that when you look at the sky, what you are actually looking at is water. Water. And it's telling us in the book of Job that were you there when he spread out the sky, which is not weak, but strong, and which was molded after a mirror that showed its images. When God chased Satan and his followers out of heaven. The place where they settle down into is inside the waters. Remember, nobody knows when water was created. We all met water here. When you look at all these scriptures, then you will now begin to understand what Revelation chapter 12 verse 12 says. You will have a clearer picture of what you read in Revelation chapter 12 verse 12. It says, rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe unto the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea. Why? For the devil is come down unto you, having a great wrath, because he knoweth that he has but a short time. Rejoice, ye heavens! But a woe was pronounced upon the earth and the sea. Why did heaven pronounce woe upon the sea? Because of the activities of the powers of darkness. Have you ever asked yourself what Genesis chapter 1 verse 2 meant when it says, and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. Darkness was upon the face of the deep. And then the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the water. Why is the darkness upon the face of the deep? And why is the Spirit of God not at rest, but was moving upon the face of the water? Could it be that there is something inside that water that the Spirit of God is trying to subdue and control? Could it be that the darkness that was upon the face of the deep is actually referring to the marine kingdom? Could it be that the water powers are the ones that render the earth void and formless? Because God will never create anything that is void and formless. Listen very carefully. There are three major strongholds in the Bible. Three. Number one, the heaven. The earth. Number three, the sea. Number one, the heaven. Number two, the earth. Number three, the sea. Any Christian that wants to break through in life, either in your ministry, on your career, on your marriage, on your business, you must learn how to confront these three strongholds. The kingdom of darkness is a kingdom that is highly organized. More organized than many churches. More organized than many lives. Until you know what you need to confront, you may not conquer in life. Wisdom is to know what to confront in order to conquer in life. The marine kingdom is real.
And
they are very strong. So when the Bible says you have spread out the firmament or the sky, which is very strong and which looks like a mirror that reflects, then the Bible is saying something very, very deep. There is no useless information in the Bible. There is a power relationship between the mirror of darkness and the waters. Anyone using a dark mirror to attack you is actually using the powers from the Marine Kingdom to fight you. So spiritually speaking, attack with a dark mirror is attack from the waters. I want to pray my first prayer for you right now. Any agent of darkness from the water that is attacking your peace, whatever they are now, fire will catch them. Let your amen roar like thunder. A man took a lady. To one hotel. Immediately they entered the place. There was a standing mirror. The lady screamed. Turn that mirror away. Turn that mirror away. Turn it to the wall. The man that brought her. What is so special about the standing mirror? The lady insisted. Turn it. At least something should have told the man. Hey. There is danger. But because of what he wants to eat, his brain has been turned upside down. He quickly turned the standing mirror. And the lady jumped on the bed.
Said,
I'm ready for you. And then the man said, okay, I'm coming. Let me go to the toilet to change myself. He went and removed his clothes. He came out. Instead of seeing the lady on the bed, he saw a big python. And the python was laughing. The brother looked at the door. He wanted to run out. The python said, if you try it, you will drop dead there. He started shaking. The python now said, I want to show you who I am. Now, go downstairs. Go to the bar. Buy a cold bottle of Fanta. And bring it up here. The man said, no problem. As was about to go out, the python lady warned him. If you run away, you are dead. And if you tell anybody what you are seeing here, that's the end of your life. He said, I promise, I won't tell anybody. And he was shaking. He went down to the bar. Give me a bottle of Fanta. But the way he was shaking, the barman said, any problem? What's going on?
He
said, it's fine. It's fine. He brought the Fanta up. The Python lady was still waiting on the bed. I said, any satanic agent that is assigned against your destiny, wherever they are, they will catch fire now. The Python lady spoke.
So,
move close to me and pour that cold Fanta on her body, starting from the tail. The man with the shaking hand, move close to this big Python and began to pour the Fanta on the body. The body, immediately the Fanta finished, the serpent shook itself. And right there, transformed. The lady is there again. Nobody taught that man. Nobody preached to him again. Not to carry a strange girl anywhere anymore. 90% of the confusion and tragedies in our world today is actually coming from the
waters.
All the latest fashions, latest this, latest that, that is taking the heart of people away from God, they are coming directly from the water. Let me tell you this tonight. Whether you believe it or not, it does not change the truth. There are more human beings living inside the waters than on planet Earth. There are so many human beings who are not human beings who came directly from the waters. When you climb Oshodi Bridge, come and see the seed of hairs of people. Many of those hairs, they are not human beings. But they will look like human beings. Woe befalls that man or that woman who has had sex with them before. Woe befalls that man or that woman who has had business transaction with them before. Woe befalls that man or that woman who has allowed their prophet or their pastors to lay their hands on their head. Anyone that has had contact with them before, and you carry no fire in your bones, such a life can never, never remain the same again. The destiny will have been tampered with. Tonight, anything taken away from your destiny by agents from the waters, by fire, by force, I command them to release it now! In the name of Jesus. The only group of people who should not really bother to pray tonight are those who had no contact with water before. You have never seen water before. You don't drink water. You don't travel on water. You don't have water inside your body. You have nothing to do with water. If you are like that, you are okay. We are okay. Just don't worry about the prayer. But if it is not so, don't joke with tonight's warfare. Do they worship water in your family? You need to pray here tonight. You may have given your life to Jesus, but that idol is still running after your destiny. Do you come from a place where they will first of all dedicate the children to the goddess River? Then you need to pray here tonight. Have you ever thrown something inside the river before? Either for protection, for power, or for fame, or for anything. I know someone who bought a bag of rice, a bag of gari, yam, clothes, all those items, and went and threw them inside the river. Have you done that before? Have you ever taken bath in a flowing river before, which was supervised by a white garment prophet or a herbalist? Has your head been washed before, so that bad luck can leave you alone? Do you always dream of seeing a large body of water? Do you have a name that is attached to a river? Are you being attacked by spirit husband, spirit wife, or you have a spirit children? Have you ever been accused of having a familiar spirit before? Are you from a riverine area? Do you find it very difficult to receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit? Do you always have this feeling that somebody is following you around? Somebody is following you around. You have that feeling. Then, tonight, is your night of freedom. We were praying for a man some years back. He said he came from the water kingdom. He told us that he lives more inside the water than on planet Earth. This man said many people's wealth, certificate, money, what they are asking for, which God has released already, have been chained inside the water. This man brought so many items for us to destroy. One of the items was a mirror. We ask him, what do you do with this mirror? He said that is what linked him with the powers, with the powers from the water. Anything that is on planet Earth, as long as that mirror is on his neck, say that is what connects him to the power base in the water. And this young man worked in one of the banks here in Nigeria. He's a banker, but he's from the water. He told us that he has three major assignments. So number one is to bring souls into the marine kingdom. So number two, to capture people's virtues and then transfer it into the waters inside their banks there. That they have banks there. So number three, to introduce high blood pressure, cancer, all those killing sicknesses into the bodies of women. And he told us that he had destroyed thousands of lives. We ask him, how did you carry out this operation? So in three ways. So number one, by sleeping with them. So number two, by kissing them. So number three, by touching their breasts, either deliberately or mistakenly. I'm praying for somebody here tonight. Any agent from the water assigned against your destiny shall die tonight in the name of Jesus. A threefold amen. Attack with a dark mirror. It's an attack from the water. And it can lead to so many things. It can lead to spiritual blindness. The person will not see where he's supposed to see, what he's supposed to see. It can lead to heavy disappointment. The kind of disappointment that you cannot explain. It can lead to blockages. Blockages. It can lead to hardship of all kinds. It can lead to unnecessary tiredness. Just getting tired all the time. After, even though you have not done any hard work, just getting tired. Getting tired. It can lead to constant harassment from the dead. It can lead to frustration. Attack from this agent can lead to chronic poverty. It can lead to memory failure. It can lead to giving birth to strange and rebellious children. It can lead to opportunity failure. It can lead to environmental oppression. It can lead to marital failure. It can lead to uncontrollable sexual urge. It can lead to backsliding. It can lead to hardness of the heart. The person will just harden his heart to truth or to good advice. And most importantly, it can also lead to untimely death. Tonight is a night of warfare. Tonight is a man that you must not joke with any of these satanic agents.
Tonight
is a man that you have to break this satanic mirror. They are everywhere. But thank God, we have the name of Jesus, we have the blood of Jesus, and we have the word of God. The most shocking information about this mirror altar is that a person's life can be tied to it. They will just tie the person's life to it. So the destiny is being controlled from somewhere else. And when that happens, the person will just notice that he is only existing but not living. But thank God for somebody here tonight. The fire of God is going to fight your battle. How do you break this mirror of darkness, which is connected to the powers in the water? Number one, you must be translated from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of light. That means you must be born again. If you are not born again and you are attacking them, you are looking for serious trouble. You must give your life totally, completely to Jesus Christ. Number two, fear must die in your life. As believers, you are not supposed to be afraid of them. The Bible says, resist the devil and he will flee from you. Fear must die in your life. And the third thing that you need to do is to fight back with warfare songs and warfare prayer. You fight back. You fight back with warfare songs and with warfare prayer. When you know the power that is in prayer, then you don't have any other problem at all. In our former church, one day like that, we are having the revival service. The anointing of God came down heavily that day. And we just noticed that one girl in the choir just began to scream unnecessarily. Say, fire is burning me. Fire is burning me. We know you now. Why should fire be burning you? But because we have to close the service that day. So our father and the Lord took her, said, you have to follow me to the house. And you know, we live together there. So that night, so we are going to pray now. We are going to pray for this girl now. And the girl began to beg us, please don't pray. Please don't pray. Say, what do you mean? Are you not a Christian? You are in that choir now. Oh, we have to pray. Say, please don't pray. She knelt down and began to cry and began to beg us. Say, why? Said, actually, there is a calabash inside her stomach. Say, eh? Calabash? Who gave it to you? Where did they get it from? So it was given to her by mommy water. And you are in your choir. Singing. So what are we going to do now? So the only way is for the person who puts the calabash inside her stomach to come and remove it. Are you saying that mommy water will come here? To come and pick the calabash?
He
said yes.
Okay, Ben, sir.
Ah, we are so happy. We have been hearing mommy water. We have never seen her before. So what are we going to do now? He said we should go and fetch water. So the Jew said, kindly, oh yeah, go inside the kitchen, bring water. Me, I'm so excited because for the first time, at least I'm going to see mommy water. So I quickly fetched the water and gave it to her. We are all watching her. She knelt down. Put her left finger, one finger, inside the water. And began to stir the water. And as she was stirring the water, she began to speak in tongues. The kind of tongues that if you are beside her, you'll be praying, oh Lord, give me this kind of tongue. Very fluent. Say, hey. We're going to watch. She will stir the water. And then she will scream. Mami water.
No, so la soke atu paru mami water. Iye moja.
Call.
Soka lewa.
We are watching.
Adetile awo.
You are laughing. It's not a laughing matter. So we are watching.
We're
waiting for the mami water to appear. So what is going on? Says she's going to call her again. That she says she's having a meeting with Lucifer. We said, look, call her now before we start praying fire prayer.
She said,
please don't pray. I will call. There is power in prayer. She called again. We waited. So what's going on? Said Mamu Wata said, well, that she's not coming. That there are giants standing by the door. So we all went to open the door. We could not see anything. There is no giant here. But we knew that there are angels of God standing there. At the end of the day, we have to break that calabash inside her stomach. I know this sister very well. Because we used to live in the same compound. This house that is facing me and facing you, you want to go take your bath, you have to queue. Anytime she enters the bathroom, you will have to pray for her to come out on time. It was that day we knew what was happening anytime she entered the bathroom. She told us that anytime she entered the bathroom, she would turn to a fish and enter into the bucket and begin to play there. Please rise up. If you notice anyone not praying with holy madness, suspect. They are everywhere. There are 52 attributes, 52 signs through which you can know them.
52.
Once you see those signs, they are from the water. Close your eyes now. Our concern here tonight is that anyone using this dark mirror that is connected to the Marie Kingdom against you to attack you or anything that belongs to you that is inside their bank, we want to fight tonight so that your possession can be released from their camp. You are not here by chance tonight. Ask the Lord to empower you now. Because you need an empowerment. You need special anointing. Special power from above to attack this satanic weapon. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. If you are in this service tonight and you want to give your life to Jesus, just say this short prayer with me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come before you tonight. I surrender my heart to you. Take control of my life. Write my name in the book of life. Thank you for accepting me. Amen. If you said that short prayer with me, immediately after the service, our ministers will be waiting for you to see you and to counsel you and to pray more with you. Once this prayer is called, if you love your life, you love your destiny, please don't joke with it. Before God can answer prayer, the prayer must be said. Can you say this with a very loud shout? Say, every power from the waters attacking my glory, scatter in the name of Jesus. It's a battle. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. As you pray this second prayer, what the Lord will show to you tonight in your dream will shock you. Say this loud and clear. My case file inside the waters. Say it with a shout. I didn't hear your voice at all. Catch fire in the name of Jesus. Fight it out, fight it out, fight it out. In Jesus' name we pray. The Lord said to me that as many as will roar this next prayer point in holy anger, that the kind of breakthrough that will happen to them will come suddenly. Say, any evil king inside the waters, sitting on my career, whatever you want to put there, you can put there. Or either your certificate, or your head, or your husband, or your wife, or your money, or your possession, whatever that is of a concern to you, put it there. Say, any evil king inside the waters, sitting on my career, you are a liar. You are a liar. You are a liar. In the name of Jesus. Marika Poto Sokotaya Baba. That is why you are here tonight. It's a battle. It's a battle. It is a battle. In Jesus' name we pray. This next prayer point is a prayer of shout. If you notice that things are always very hard for you to get, you have to fight, you have to struggle, you have to do this before you can get them. Please pray this next prayer point. It is a prayer of shout. My virtue inside the waters. Come out. Come out. In the name of Jesus. Don't joke with this prayer. Don't joke with this prayer. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, mirror of darkness, controlling my destiny, break in the name of Jesus. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. In Jesus' name we pray. If you notice anyone that did not pray this next prayer point with holy anger, maybe it's one of them. Shout this one loud. Marine deposits inside my body. I didn't hear your voice at all. Say it loud.
It's okay.
Catch fire. In the name of Jesus. That's right. Say it out. Say it out. Say it out. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We are going to repeat that prayer again. There is a man here. The angel of the Lord is beside you. And is holding a crown. He wants to put that crown on your head. But the way you are praying is not encouraging the angel. If God opens your eyes to see what is happening here tonight, you will praise God. Marine deposits inside my body. Catch fire in the name of Jesus. That is how to pray the prayer. That is how to do it. That is how to do it. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Two more prayers. Two more prayers. And look, these two remaining prayer. The assignment of this prayer is to open doors that have been shut against you. Can you say this with a very loud voice? The kingdom of Marine. Hear the word of the Lord. Release my testimonies.
So
in the name of Jesus. Release my testimony. Rasiketari Potushichiana. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. This is the last one. Let your hand, your leg, your body participate in this prayer. Can you say this loud and clear? Herbalist. From the waters, holding my key of joy. Say it again loud and clear. I didn't hear your voice at all. Say it with a shout. Release it now! In the name of Jesus! Release it, release it! Release the key! Glory be to the name of the Lord! Mushikatanda Ruboto Fotoya! Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I want to pray this one prayer for you. Anyone that is not happy because of the way you have prayed here tonight, any power that is not happy because of the way you have attacked them tonight, any organization that is not happy because of the way you have prayed here tonight, I command their sorrows to multiply. In the name of Jesus. The Lord said, I should tell somebody here tonight that the sickness that you are seeing now, you shall see it no more. God has ushered thousands here tonight into the realm of victory. You will notice right now that things will just begin to work in your favor very fast, 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 very fast. And so shall it be in the name of Jesus. It is time for our Father in law to pray on our waters now.
Let your amen roar like fire and like thunder. This is not an ordinary prayer. And after the prayer, that water is not an ordinary water. Father, in the name of Jesus. 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 Father, we commit this water unto your holy hands. You are the water of life. Father, in your power as the water of life.
Baba,
enter into these waters in the name of Jesus. Let this water become the water of power. The water of deliverance. The water of strength. The water of glory. The water of fire. The water of breakthrough. The water of prosperity. As many as will have contact with this water, their lives will no longer remain the same in the name of
Jesus.
Let your power flow into you. Let your energy flow into you. Water. Hear the word of the Lord. Receive the anointing of breakthrough. Receive it. In the name of Jesus. Makatenda likaya, ribo sepinda likatunda kaya, baribo sepande kaya boshente, dakapia likaja, diramo sepia lika. Let this water become divine tonic, divine antibiotic, divine medication. In the name of Jesus. The Lord blesses you from Zion. Make His face to shine upon you. And be gracious unto you. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Father, all the prayer requests are answered them by
prayer.
In Jesus' name, we pray. Let us share the grace in fellowship.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Seven thunders, hallelujah.